Hello everybody, Discount Chugga Conroy here. Welcome back to another episode of Pokemon Soul Silver. In the last episode, we got here to Mr. Pokemon's house and delivered... Well, we didn't deliver anything. We got the mystery egg to deliver to Professor Elm. And in this episode, we're going to be doing just that. We also got a call from Professor Elm claiming there was an emergency at the lab. So we should probably go check that out too while we're at it. And, of course, I did grind a little off-screen on accident, actually, but, whatever. It doesn't matter that much. It's not a big difference, anyway. Okay, well. Still, I'm not going over encounters yet. I might later in the episode, I don't know entirely, but I will be going over encounters, rest assured. If I'm sane while I'm editing, actually, let's check this. Go, Rattata, tackle! What? This is a big battle! Leave me alone! In the original Gold and Silver, the battle music actually started playing there. I don't know why they would remove that of all things in the remakes, but whatever. We're on Cherry Grove again. Let's just go heal up real quick, because there is something coming up that you're going to want to be healed for. Yes, heal me. You got a Pokemon in the lab. What a waste. That's a Pokemon that's too good for a wimp like you. Don't you get what I'm saying? Well, I too have a good Pokemon. I'll show you what I mean. This is just a very underrated rival theme, and I don't know why people don't pay more attention to it, but anyway. His only Pokemon is Cyndaquil, level 5, knowing Tackle and Leer. Since our Chikorita's already level 8, it should be okay. If you chose either of the other starters, he would either have Totodile with Scratch and Growl, or Chikorita with Tackle and Growl. Cyndaquil's the only one that gets Leer, which is interesting. Anyway, though, that's done. Sorry I sped that up. It's just that... It's such a pointless battle. Are you happy you won? Do you want to know who I am? I'm going to be the world's greatest Pokemon trainer. And he kicked us again. Give it back. That's my trainer card. Oh no. You saw my name. Damn right I did, passerby boy. His name is Boy. Better report that to the police. As if there are police in the Pokemon world. Okay, can't get through that way. Just a minor inconvenience. At most... Okay, Oh, Sentret. I love Sentret. It's so cute. Oh my god, this again. Close that. No. Close it. Yep. Alright. I honestly... This ROM is just... I'm less playing this on a ROM because I don't have a DS capture card yet. Rest assured, when I get one, I will be, like, changing over to a... actual DS, but for now, whatever. Let's head into the lab. Who are you? We're investigating the case of missing Pokemon here. Rule number one, whoever did it will come back to the site. Oh my, so you must be the one who did it? Hold on a sec, she has nothing to do with it. I saw it. There was a red-haired boy looking into this building. What? You battled a boy like that? He must be the one who did it. Did you happen to get his name? Yeah, he got his trainer class too, in fact. His name was Boy. I see, so Boy was his name. Thanks for helping my investigation. My next assignment is to search for this red-haired individual. Ashley, I'm glad they understand you're innocent. See you later. Thanks for bailing me out of being the next Ace Attorney defendant. Ashley, this is terrible. Oh yeah, what was Mr. Pokemon's big discovery? Huh? This is an egg, isn't it? This egg may be something I've never seen. Still, it's just an egg. Mr. Pokemon is always fascinated by eggs. Well, since he gave it to us, we might as well try to find out what secret it holds. I'll keep it for a while and, I'll keep it for a while to find out about the egg. What? Professor Oak gave you a Pokedex. Ashley, is that true? That's incredible. He's superb at seeing the potential of people as trainers. Wow, Ashley. I knew you were a little different. Things are going to be fun. Your Pokemon seem to really like you, so why don't you take the Pokemon Gym Challenge? If you manage to defeat all the gym leaders, you'll eventually challenge the Pokemon League champion. Or not. becoming the champion is not all easy, but you can certainly challenge Violet City's gym. Ashley, challenging the gym scattered around will be a long journey. Before you leave, make sure that you talk to your mom. You know, before, when we tried to leave without telling Mom, this lady stopped us. This time no one's stopping us because we got a Pokemon. There you are. Ashley, you can catch wild Pokemon with Pokeballs. Follow me. And there he goes with his Meryl, a Pokemon that we will not be seeing for quite a while. So I won't be going over a bio for it yet. He's showing how to catch Pokemon. If you've played Pokemon or even just seen the anime, you know how to catch Pokemon. You just weaken it and throw a Pokeball. Whatever, though. See? Just like that. It's better to lower your target's HP more than I did, or make it sleep or something. You can try all kinds of things to see what works. I'll give you these. Good luck. And he will give us the Pokeballs. See ya. And now that we have the Pokeballs, I don't see any better time to go over bios on Route 29 than now. So, I'll see you in just a sec. Starting off the wild Pokemon on Route 29, we have Pidgey. Pidgey is the same as it was in Fire Red. It's a generic normal flying type. It has speed. It has mixed attacking stats with attack and special attack being even, I think? And I'd recommend more of a special Pidgey for when it's fully evolved in Pidgeot. As you can see in the bio, I did make a slight mistake because it turns out Pidgey was buffed in Generation 6, but this is Gen 4, so its speed is still 91 when fully evolved. That being said, it's still a decent choice, and I wouldn't pass it off because it's normal. It's not as bad as you'd think. Next up is Sentret. Sentret is interesting. Early game Sentret and Furret, its evolved form are fine. It just really falls behind later on and eventually becomes nothing more than an HM slave, which is unfortunate because Furret is actually one of my favorite design Pokemon. Sentret can be used for a lot of things. It has decent defensive stats and semi-decent attacking stats. So,
In fact, I've actually used it in competitive before with Follow Me. Follow Me is awesome on Sentret. But there's not much more to say about it, honestly. It gets Kenai for an ability, so early game when you're going up against a bunch of Pidgeys, that can be helpful, I guess. But that's all I really have to say about it. Next, we have Hoot Hoot. Hoot Hoot is another normal flying type. Go figure. But this time it's relatively defensive, which is kind of weird. It has very high special defense, which is something you don't see very often in flying types, and it's honestly not very helpful. That being said, don't pass it up. Noctowl has decent attacking stats, and it learns a lot of psychic type moves on. Like, I don't know why. I guess because owls are associated with being wise, I guess. But there are better flying types you can get in this game, so I guess I'd recommend waiting, but if you don't want to, if you're like a huge owl fan or something, definitely pick up Noctowl. Or Hoot Hoot. And last on Route 29 is Rattata. I feel so bad for Rattata, because it doesn't really even work as an HM slave. Its stats fall behind so quickly when it's fully evolved, and it doesn't get the hidden ability of Hustle yet in this generation, meaning it's going to be falling behind very quickly and not learning very strong attacking moves. It learns Hyper Fang and Crunch, that's about as good as you'll get on it. And it can't learn a lot of the attacking moves that other normal types can. So, for those reasons, it doesn't get a recommendation from me. It's just a very, like, it's just bad. But we will be seeing why everyone loves Rattata later on in the series. In fact, probably in this episode. So, yeah. So those bios all done. While I was battling, while doing the bios, Chikorita actually leveled up and learned Poison Powder. I believe it's 75 accuracy move that poisons the opponent, not badly poison. There is a difference between the two. Badly poison increases every turn, poison just damages every turn and on the field. So that's a good move. As I said earlier, Chikorita is very much more of a support Pokemon. When compared to other starters. And I'm actually a big fan of that. I really like Chikorita. I didn't actually take any damage, and I don't intend to buy anything here, so. With that, it's time to move on to even more bios. Are you ready? I hope so. First off, we have Caterpie. Caterpie's evolution line is meh. You can only find it here in Heart Gold version. That being said, I don't know why you'd want to use one. Caterpie is not great. It learns no moves other than Tackle and String Shot. When it evolves into Metapod, it gets Hardened, and then when it evolves into Butterfree, early on in the game, yes, you will destroy a lot of things because Butterfree gets Psybeam and Gust, but Butterfree falls behind very quickly as soon as you get farther in the game, just because it doesn't learn the moves to support it. It doesn't even get a flying type move to support its flying type. So I'm not going to be recommending Caterpie through Butterfree. Of course, I'm not stopping you. If you want to use them, then go right ahead. Next up we have Weedle, only available in Soul Silver, a bug poison type. For some reason classified as the hairy bug Pokemon, even though there is no hair visible on its body. It evolves into Kakuna. It starts with Poison Sting and String Shot, evolves into Kakuna and gets Hardened, and then evolves into Beedrill where it will get Fury Attack. I don't understand why Fury Attack, because it was designed to help against Brock in the first game, but Fury Attack's not very effective. So yeah, I don't understand that. Next up, we have Ledyba, Ledibot, only available in Soul Silver. It's a very bad bug type. I don't know why it's called the 5-star Pokemon, because it gets anything but 5 stars when it comes to competitive ranking. It's very special specially defensive, which isn't good for it in particular, because it has a 4x weakness to rock. And the rock type is very physical when it comes to attacking. In the middle of these bios, I beat Youngster Joey, and he's saying he's going to give me his number. This is something trainers can do in this game. They can give you their number. After you beat them, they will call you from time to time and give you items sometimes. I'm going to say yeah, no right now, but maybe later on I'll show it off. That's where a meme stems from, because he has a top percentage Rattata. Anyway. Next up, we have we just went over Caterpie. So we have Spinarak next. Spinarak is only available in Heart Gold. It's another bug poison type, and this time it is much better than Ledibot. Spinarak and Ariados have decent stats. They're possible to work with throughout the entire game, and hey, in Gen 7, they actually got a huge buff. So there's nothing much holding me back from recommending it. Just be careful, because it has a lot of weaknesses, and it will fall behind later in the game. So now that we have that out of the way, we have our first trainer battles here. Honestly, the music for trainer battles in Gen 2 and Gen 4 is very lackluster, and I think they could have done a lot better a job when they were remixing it for Gen 4, but whatever. Either way, Chikorita is absolutely destroying, and we aren't going to get our next team member quite yet, so that's unfortunate. If we talk or not, that's fine. Just another Hoot Hoot. What else would it be? If you talk to this girl, I'm not a trainer, but if you look one in the eyes, prepare to battle. And case in point, here's a bug catcher. Instead of a bug Pokemon, I found a trainer. Be thankful that bug catchers do not get bug type moves yet if you chose Chikorita, because this Caterpie would be destroying Chikorita. Actually, Caterpie and Weedle do get Bug Bite at level 15, but I don't know why you'd train them to level 15, because they evolve into Metapod and Kakuna at level 7. So that's just kind of pointless, and I don't know why they went with that decision. Whatever. It's all good. Bug Catcher Don is going to go up for another Caterpie. Who would have thought? I'm just going to speed this up, because nobody wants to watch Chikorita destroy another Caterpie. If you do, you need to get your priorities straight. I'm sorry. These string shots are getting annoying. And there goes Bug Catcher Don. Arg, you're too strong! I know, right? Tell that to myself all the time. And if you get here, Mom will call you. Hello? Ashley? I heard from Professor Elm that you went on a long trip. I wish you would have told me. What about your money? Should I save it? So here you can tell your mom to save your money or not save your money. I'm going to say save it, because she can get you some rare items if you let her save your money. But if you're in Gold, Silver, and Crystal in particular, do not let her save your money, because she will actually just buy you useless berries that you can find scattered throughout the entire region. Anyway, now that we're on Route 30, or 31, and we found the new encounter on Route 31, time to go over the new encounter. Bellsprout and its evolutions are actually very decent grass poison types. They have mixed attack stats, which is always a plus. And they learn some decent moves. Chlorophyll is an okay ability. It's better on a Sunlight team, and since you won't be having a Sunlight team here, I can't say I recommend that. But I am going to be catching a Bellsprout for something you'll see a little bit later. So, yeah. Victory Bell is alright. It has a good attack stat, so that's kind of weird, actually. It learns a lot of special grass-type moves. I don't know why they would give it a decent attack stat when compared to special attack. But it does learn some physical poison and grass moves, so don't let it hold you back. Okay, and we caught it. Okay, that's good. You know what? I'm not gonna name it, because, you know, you'll see. It plants its feet deep underground to replenish water. It can't escape its enemy while it's rooted. That's kinda dark. Poor Bellsprout. So if we come up here, you'll notice here there is a sign, and it leads into a place called Dark Cave. Very creative name. If we head in, you will see that it is, quite literally, a dark cave. There are some new encounters in here which I will go over right now, but I am just going to continue to the next city. So in Dark Cave you can find Zubat. Contrary to what you might have heard, while Zubat is annoying to encounter over and over again in caves, it's actually a good Pokemon. It has a very high speed stat all throughout its evolution line. It learns some very strong moves for a Zubat, like eventually it learns Wing Attack, which will destroy most Pokemon. And it even, like, it evolves into Golbat relatively early, level 21 or 25? Around that level. And not only that, but Crobat is tied for the fastest Pokemon in this game. So, that's always something to look at when you're trying to gauge between what flying type you're going to use. Next up we have is Geodude. If you watch my Fire Red Let's Play, you will remember that I used a Geodude. Geodude's alright. It has a very good attack and defense stat, but everything else is kind of horrible. But if you have a friend to trade with, and you can get it all the way to Golem, it is... like, it's going to be able to hold its own, so I recommend that. If you want more information, it's one of the few Pokemon I actually did a bio for in my Fire Red Let's Play, so you can go check that out. It's the Mount Moon episode, I think the one with the Zubats all over the thumbnail, I don't know. And last, with only a quarter chance of appearing, is Dunsparce. I feel very bad for Dunsparce. It was just ripped off all throughout its existence. Dunsparce can learn so many moves, it's ridiculous how many it can learn, actually. But it doesn't evolve, and its stats stay exactly the same. Its HP is its only really good stat, and it's not really worthwhile to train, which feels horrible to say, because I love Dunsparce. But unfortunately, it's just not a good Pokemon, so... yeah, that's real unfortunate. Got a Pokeball here. So that's great. Just gonna continue. We're almost done here. Another Bellsprout. I don't need one of those. Stop it, with the wild encounters. I don't need more Hoot Hoots. If you couldn't tell, DS Pokemon games, wild encounters are kinda ridiculous. They really did fix it in 3DS, but it was just very bad here. I knew it was you, Ashley. How did you get past me? Here's something neat for surprising me, Ashley. And you will obtain a Verse Recorder. The Verse Recorder can record your Pokemon battles. I have to go now. I won't let you pass me again. What he said just now about the Verse Recorder being able to record your Pokemon battles is a huge insult, because it can't anymore. It can, kind of, but it's only local now. It used to be able to record Wi-Fi battles, which, of course, are shut down now with Nintendo Wi-Fi connection. So that's unfortunate. Anyway, we're here in Violet City now. We care about the traditional buildings around here. That's why even the Pokemart and Pokemon Center are painted a bit somberly to blend in. Yeah, as you can see, the Pokemon Center is a deeper red.
Shard the berry! Shard the berry! Yeah, yeah! I've 3 berry for a shard! If you bring me some shards, I will give you 3 berries, yeah!
I don't remember that NPC at all. There have been reports of ghost-type Pokemon appearing in Sprout Tower. They say normal-type Pokemon moves have no effect on them. Absolutely true. Think this is the house? Kid, stop. I collect Pokemon. Okay, yep. Do you have a Bellsprout? Want to trade it for my Onix? Yeah. Onix is the second member of my team. Bellsprout will be traded to Rudy. Bye-bye, Bellsprout. Dramatic trade sequence. And down comes the Pokeball with our newest team member. Rocky. I hope you'll pardon me for playing the Rocky theme during this bio. Okay. Onix is a very, very, very physically bulky Pokemon. That being said, just about every other stat is abysmal. It has decent attack and speed, but like special defense, it will not be surviving a special water or grass type move, which is unfortunate because it has 4 times weakness to both of those types. Not only that, it doesn't learn many moves to counter those types, but Onix is just a very cool Pokemon, and I really like it, so deal with it, as they say on the internet. Anyway, I think that's where we're gonna stop for today. We got a new team member, holding a Petcha Berry, or a Person Berry. Okay. Very confused for a sec, because there's absolutely no reason for it to be holding a Person Berry, because it will not be poisoned. It's gonna get poisoned the next episode now that I said that. But anyway, we got a new team member with a horrible nature. We got through a lot of bios. Just a lot of bios. So that's where we're gonna end for today. In the next episode, we are going to be just continuing. We're going to be going to the Sprout Tower, which is what we need to do before we get to the gym. See you guys then.